Everybody knows 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, but I know 2 is the same as 1 plus 1. Okay, let's do some math for fun. Here we are going to compute the square root of 500 times 500, 1 times 500, 2 times 503, and then plus 1. Everything is inside of the square root. Of course, we will not be using a calculator because otherwise, where's the fun, right? And as always, please pause the video and try this first. Okay, hopefully you guys have a chance to try it. And let me tell you guys that the answer to this right here is 25, and then 15, and then 0, 1, like this. Yeah, of course, I didn't do this in my head. I did this beforehand, and I memorized the answer, and I just put on the answer for you guys. But anyway, I'll show you guys how to do this right here. And here's the deal. Whenever the question is asking you to compute some crazy-looking expression without a calculator, usually, don't use a calculator, use algebra for it. Of course, if you can use a calculator, it's the easiest, but if you are using a calculator, why are you watching my video for this, right? So, we will make some observation, so we can see how to change this into an algebra equation. And as we all know, the easiest way to compute a square root is that we hope the inside is just a perfect square. That's the best one, right? So maybe the inside is actually the perfect square, you will see. So here we go. Let me write this down right here for you guys. We will make some observations. First of all, notice that we do have a nice pattern right here. And if you call the first number to be x, and the next number will be x plus 1, and then we have x plus 2, and this number will be x plus 3. And don't forget the plus 1 right here as well. And now, don't multiply this out in combinators entirely, because that would be just as bad as doing this by hand in the first place, right? Let's see. First of all, though, you might be wondering, could we let this be x? So that this is x minus 1, and this is x plus 1 and x plus 2. Will that be easier? You can give it a try. I will continue from here, right? So let's see. Well, seriously, we are not going to multiply everything out. But if you look at, because you have done so algebra so many times, if you multiply this and that, you get some really nice expression. And let me write that down right here for you guys. Again, just this and that. We will end up x squared plus 3x plus 2. And this is very nice. Because if you multiply out the rest, which is this x with the x plus 3 right here, they are going to be very similar because you are going to get x squared plus 3. And notice, this right here has the plus 2. This right here is just the first two terms right here. So they are pretty similar to each other. And don't forget the plus 1 right here at the end. And now, here's the deal. Everybody knows 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. But I know 2 is the same as 1 plus 1.
Whoa!
I feel like a genius already. Check this out. Look at this 2. I'm going to look at the 2 as 1 plus 1. And by doing so, I can look at the inside as 4 terms. This, and that. Right? And I have this in front. So I will distribute this carefully. First of all, this is how we will do it. I will take this right here and distribute it with the first 3 terms. So we will end up x squared plus 3x, and then the first 3 terms inside of this parentheses, we get x squared plus 3x plus 1, like this. And then we'll take this times the 1, which is just that by itself, right? So we can just write down plus x squared plus 3x times 1, which doesn't matter. And then, thankfully, we have another plus 1 right here. That's very nice. And you'll see that. This is technically our first term because you have this times that. And then you have this right here. This is the same as that. So we can actually factor this and that out. Very nice. So here's the deal. I will factor this out. We get x squared plus 3x plus 1. And the leftover is this right here, which is x squared plus 3x. And just like your algebra teacher will tell you, don't forget it's like this, and you have the 1 right here. So you have to put down the plus 1, like this. Very nice. As you all know, the best friend of black pen is, of course, red pen. This and that, they are best friends. Why? Because together they produce a perfect square. So we get x squared plus 3x plus 1 to the second power. This is very nice. And now, the original expression is just going to be, you can put this inside, and of course this and that will cancel. Very nice. And you just get x squared plus 3x plus 1, and you put 500 in there. So you get parentheses 500 squared plus 3 times 500, and then plus 1. Man, seriously, you guys, don't you guys just love the good old algebra days? Right? Anyway, you multiply everything, you get that number. So this is it. Maybe you guys noticed, this is very similar to the answer that we got from a video right a few days ago. You guys can leave a comment down below and let me know what the video is all about, right? Which video am I talking about? Okay, in one of my previous videos, some of you guys asked me about the divisibility rules, so I'm going to show you guys more about this right here on Boolean Network. First of all, I want to thank them for sponsoring this video, and I also want to show you guys about their new feature called the Daily Challenges. And they happen to have this question for today. What's the remainder when you have 1111111 divided by 3? I think the answer is 0, and I'm going to submit that, and I got it correct. Of course, because I know the secret, and if you guys want to know more about the secret, of course, you have to go check out the solutions, and maybe I'll do the video right here for you guys as well. But the interesting thing is that I think many of you guys know about the divisibility rule for number 3, but how about the other ones? If you would like to know more, you guys can go check it out, this right here, right, for the quizzes. So, if you have about like 5-10 minutes per day, you can just pull this out and then you can continue your learning, right, while you are just enjoying your coffee and all that. And I think it's really, really cool. And maybe I'll do another one for you guys to just show off. This right here is actually not divisible by 3. And I got it correct, of course. And they also offer a lot of interesting courses. So if you want to sign up for the annual premium subscription, be sure you guys use the link blackpenredpen, because this way you guys can get 20% off discount and you can get access for all of their courses. Another question for you guys is this a prime number? Just think about it as well. Very cool question. Anyway, hopefully you guys all like this video. If you do, please give me a like. If you're new to my channel, be sure to subscribe. Thank you guys so much. And as always, that's it.